say, the future of our lives as women in technology. So, Caprena.
Good morning, ladies. So, I don't want to give away their presentation because they worked extremely hard on it. But I am very happy to have today with us Girls to Program. So, we have Sara, Alejandra, Maria. So, these girls will tell you their story, but basically, they are women in tech. And they have learned how to code at Amini Vinci, which is a center led by Patricia, which we will know more about. So I don't want to step on their presentation, but please, huge welcome to these wonderful girls. Woo!
Hello, everyone. We are so happy to be here with you. Thank you so much for inviting us, for showing us Facebook and Instagram, and for giving us the opportunity to tell you our story. We are from Huesca. It is a very small town in the Pyrenees Mountains, very close to France. It's a great place to live, very safe, and where you can go walking everywhere. But it also has lots of limitations. We don't have many of the things people have in big cities like Madrid. We don't have any private high school. We don't have any specialized activities in the weekend, and we don't have academies that can teach things that offer it in other bigger cities. The four of us love technology and did some stuff at home. We watch lots of videos on YouTube. We play with robotic Legos, and we did things that our parents recommended. But 2 years ago, we were super lucky and a technology academy opened in Huesca, the first and only one in the province. The only bad thing about the academy is that all the students were boys. But then, more girls were coming to the workshop and were telling us how good technology was. Now there are so many girls in Mini Vinci. We participate in the International Challenge Innovation Challenge. We have been very lucky, but we know in small cities that most girls in small cities like Huesca or in towns in Spain have no access to courses or to technology classes, and in countries outside of Spain, this is much worse. Without technology teachers, without academies, and without access to courses or to technology programs. We participate in the International Talent Innovation Challenge. We thought this was We participate in the International Talent Innovation Challenge, and we thought this was a great opportunity to help another girls. We started loving technology, finding videos on YouTube. We want to help another girl from all over the world, and we want. And we want to give them the possibility of thousands of videos. This is G2P.
That's right, Sarah. That was the beginning of this wonderful adventure. So many things have happened in the last 3 months. I remember our first meeting at Mini Vinci, where we put many names on the whiteboard to name the app we were going to create. We thought Girls to Program was a really cool name. Then Patricia working on all the things we needed to do. We needed to find and upload as many videos as possible. Videos that we have seen in the past on YouTube, that we could add to the app. We have to talk to our friends and see what channels they were using. Then we have to sort out the most important categories for the MVP of the app. Yes, we learned that minimum viable product is we have to have the minimum things, we did not have much time. Then Patricia had to program a lot, so we now she was doing that teaching as the code we have to add. And then we added more functionality to the app. This is our app, Girls to Program, video with a little demo on the app.
This is our app, Girls to Program. Here's the logo. And then the sign up or login page. We are gonna log in with our email. Then our password.
The security.
Here we have four categories, and where in the future we are gonna make more. Here we have the videos that we've uploaded, and our goal is to have millions and hundreds of videos in. This is the first tutorial. Here is the description of each video where we click on the thumbnail, and it takes us to a video. When we finish it, we come back, and this page is to collaborate with the app. You can send us a video of your YouTube channel. If you don't want to send us anything, you come back here. Here you have the settings, and you can see the description about our group.
Wow.
The objective was clear: to help children around the world, grouping a lot of content that exists on YouTube, targeting those who do not have access to teachers or to academies. We have grouped into categories, starting with Scratch, Making, Minecraft, and Minecraft. We are working on other categories, and soon we will upload videos from Arduino, Lego Widoo, and other programs. Something very cool with the app is that we have created a collaborative functionality. We were only four girls, but each one of us follow or watch different videos or channels. What we do is to encourage each user to upload their videos or recommendations, so that any child can improve the app and upload more content, all with our supervision and approval.
We loved our app. It looked fantastic, but we wanted girls to know what we were doing. We did an exercise on the whiteboard, asking the group how many girls we knew. Only with our friends, we could get to 40 girls. Wow, 40! Next, we talked to the girls that were in Huesca. If we go to all the schools promoting the app, we can get to 500 girls. We thought it was amazing, so many people could be using our app. But then we had the idea of getting the support of famous people. Maybe someone wanted to support us. We were girls 9 and 10 years old. We are super nice, and we were doing something. We put names in a list. Lots of names of women. Shakira, Edurne, who is a Spanish singer, and a Patricia Boy from Banco Santander. Twitter account, and we prepared a video asking for help sending it to everyone in the list. This is the video we prepared.
Hola, somos un grupo de cuatro niñas de 9 y 10 años de Huesca. Participamos en un concurso internacional y queremos cambiar el mundo con una app que hemos desarrollado.
Con esta app queremos acercar la tecnología a niños y niñas que viven en ciudades pequeñas para que tengan acceso a cientos de vídeos en sus móviles y tabletas.
Necesitamos tu ayuda para llegar a miles de niñas, que se enteren de lo que estamos montando y que así ellas también puedan ayudar a más gente.
Solo te pedimos que compartas este vídeo. Si ganamos el concurso, iremos a Silicon Valley y podremos conseguir ayuda para lanzar la app mundialmente.
Podemos ayudar a muchísimas niñas con tu ayuda. Por favor, ayúdanos. Gracias.
That will be incredible, and it will give us great value for the presentation at the international contest. On May 8th, we published the following message, and then we contact one by one all the names on our list with different messages. This is the one we sent to Shakira. Hey Shakira, we don't dance as well as you do, but we want to help Girls to Program. Can you help us, please? Very simple. Shakira never responded. In fact, nobody from the list responded on the first. morning of May 10th, 2 days later. Carlos Barrabés, a very important business person in Spain, who is also from the mountains of Huesca, sent a message on his Twitter account. And then Ana Pastor, a journalist with 2 million followers, sent a message saying everyone show support to girls. And then everything went crazy. One of the most popular morning radio programs with millions of listeners talked about us. The female CEOs of Twitter and Microsoft sent us messages. The vice president of our region, the senator, the mayor of Barcelona, everyone retweeting and sending us messages of support. We got almost 6,000 retweets and we received hundreds of messages. It was amazing. And then we received requests for interviews, newspapers, radios and television. Can do all these things, anyone can do it.
Wow.